Good evening, sir, and batchmates. So we roll numbers from 56 to 66 are going to present on the topic digital marketing. We are not going to cover whole of the intricacy, but we take the maximum effort to present you not too little or not too long information.
Okay.
So this is our team, starting from myself, Ravi Kumar and Subhashini Divivedi, Sumit Sunil Rathod, Tejashwini, Trimalesh, Utkal Prasad Mahanta, Utsav Pavendra, Sainath, Vidwat, Vishal Galo, and finally Vishwanath. So I hand over the podium to the remaining batchmates. They will explore you the digital marketing session.
Fantastic. All the best.
Tejashwini, you can continue.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So actually, we all know that how digital marketing is leading in every sector. It is nothing but marketing the products or services using these digital technologies and also using digital media. Often people get confused the difference between the digital and online marketing, but online marketing is just a part of digital marketing, and this includes internet and other things. And but digital marketing includes the electronic devices, like we can also take billboards and all. So Utsav, can you take over?
Yeah, sure.
Wow.
So objectives, let us move towards objectives of digital marketing. And first objective is reach the right audience. So I will make you understand why this particular point is very important, like why reaching the right audience is very important. Like consider an example, a guy looking for a Wagoneer car, okay? And if you will project a product like Porsche to that particular man, he will not be interested. He will not at all be interested, and he will not end up buying that particular product. So you will end up approaching a wrong audience in yes. that particular case. So gaining a deep understanding of who your customers are and what motivates them will help you define a more qualified audience. Only then you can wow. use digital channels to reach the audience and derive higher quality of traffic and improve your on-site engagement. And most importantly, increase your sales. So after all, for every marketing, like driving the sales is our main motive. Wrong Utsav, he can be interested. Okay, there is some doubt in chat box, I guess. Wrong Utsav, yeah. he can be interested if you are giving it the same price. Of course, like there would be a price difference, right? A Wagoneer and a Porsche can be of same price.
And that thing you missed, you said the customer will not be interested if you are showing him Porsche.
Right. But he will be interested in seeing that, but he will not be interested in purchasing that. Actually, our main motive is to sell that particular product to that particular customer. So again, let us move towards the next point, that engagement of audience. Like consider the same example. If a customer is there and his engagement is very important, if he will not feel engaged, then what we are going to effect is like that would be the sales of the product. If he will not be able to connect with the product, if he will not be able to connect with the company, the sale will not be, like the main target of marketing will not be achieved. So digital marketing mediums like social media marketing are the best medium for such campaigns. So companies can run specific retargeting campaigns using AdWords or Facebook or Instagram only for the existing customers or people who have previously been the website visitors, showing them their new products as well. So if there is a customer which company is having already, so they can show them their new products if they are regular visitors of the website. And this is a great tool to motivate their customers. Actually, that is our third point, to motivate them to purchase that particular product. So due to this, that customer would be shown the ads while browsing social media or any blogs or through their own websites. This helps the customer to remain engaged. That customer will not feel detached from the company. That customer will remain loyal to the company. So with that, the brand will increase its own value and increase the chances of subsequent purchases. So a customer, that particular customer will stick to the same brand, and company will not end up losing that particular customer. And last but not the least, it's the most important point, that maximize your return on investment. So return on investment is like it's the major point, just because, you know, the money which you have put in and what you are gaining on that money, that is a return on investment. So digital marketing, it is one of the one of the best options for the, if you will consider return on investment, because the advertisers, the mass which we are going to cover is huge. It's huge. And the amount which we are going to invest in to target this huge audience, it is very minimal. If you will consider the local or the old traditional method, which was previously used. So you can run digital marketing campaigns due to which customers can land on your website, browse your offerings, and make purchase of online itself. Direct sales generated via digital marketing campaigns can be used to determine return on your investment, how much your revenue was generated directly for every rupee you spend in digital marketing. However, not all campaigns will result in direct sales, but they may lead in your future customers, or they may spread your customers, your products, products from customers to customers. Like if a customer is there, he experienced your product, your approach was all right, but you were not able to convert that particular pitch into the sales. But that particular person will spread a word of mouth to different people, and that may result in the subsequent sale. So there would be a assisted conversation or engagement of brand awareness which will happen due to this. So as a result, your campaign which may draw direct or indirect customers to you in a future. So thank you all. I may hand it over to
you. Thank you, Utsav, but you're taking a lot of time of your team.
Yes, sir. That's why I
understand now why you are asking a lot of time. I know now. Yes. No problem. Anyway, it's like open now. We can extend it a little bit more. But you people are doing great job.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening,
sir. Shall I start?
Yes, Subhashini, go ahead.
Okay, so I'll be taking up digital marketing areas. The first one is SEO. It stands for search engine optimization. In some simple terms, it will mean the process of improving your site to increase its visibility for relevant searches. The better the visibility of your page is, it will have better results, and more likely you are to garner attention and attract prospective and existing customers to your business. So it is a fundamental part of digital marketing, because people conduct trillions and zillions of searches every year. So often with commercial intent and non-commercial intent as well, to find information about products and services. The next is social media optimization. Social media optimization, SMO, is the use of social media networks to manage and grow an organization's message and online presence. As a digital marketing strategy, social media optimization can be used to increase awareness of new products and services connected with customers, and also ameliorate potential digital, damaging news as well. So, various social media platforms can be used for digital marketing. They include Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, YouTube, and sometimes Pinterest as well. For social media marketing, it is the use of, again, social media platforms to connect with your audience, to build your brand, increase your sales, as mentioned previously, and derive website traffic. This involves publishing great content on your social media profiles, listening and engaging with your followers, analyzing your results, and running social media advertisement in the same go. The major social media platforms I've already mentioned, those can be used for the similar purpose. Now, sometimes companies use various social media platforms. They use some tools to improve the organizational delivery of their content. So there are many tools as well available. Now, for search engine marketing, it is the practice of marketing a business using paid advertisement that appear on search engine result pages. Mm-hmm. Advertisers bid on keywords that users of services such as Google or Bing, that search engines, might enter when looking for certain products or services, which gives the advertiser the opportunity for their ads to appear alongside research of those search queries. Search engine marketing's greatest strength is that it offers advertisers the opportunity to put their ads in front of motivated customers who are ready to buy at the precise moment they are ready to make a purchase. So that's all about digital marketing areas.
Very good. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Vishal Galo. So what sets digital marketing apart from traditional marketing? So over the traditional marketing, digital marketing is always having advantages. Like first one is cost. So even if you tell about the cost of products, it gives more discount in visual. And if you talk about the advertising, that also it is beneficial. Like Subhashini explained about social media platform, like advertising on Facebook, Instagram and all. Like it gives the low, it takes low amount compared to television, printing or radio advertisement. Then if you talk about dynamic, then dynamic digital marketing also keeps our cost low. And for example, one of the major advantages, like how Manish tells about its return of investment, how it is best. In the same way, digital market also means dynamic digital marketing also tells about it. So then entertaining market.
Good evening. I am Utkal. I will be talking about the entertaining and audiovisual part.
Okay.
Am I audible?
Yeah,
Utkal, you are audible.
In the entertaining part, the web homepage, you can mention the blogs about your business plan, what you are going to give, and some animations so that keep intact your customer into your website. And putting that videos in the social media and about product awareness. Now the company, what they are doing, they are creating an timeline that in which they want contribution from the customers towards this COVID-19 pandemic. So it is also best initiative in this, which can be done through only digital media only. Next, for the audiovisual part, in which the customer can directly contact with the web part, and they can, even if they have some major problem, they can communicate with the managers regarding their feedback and the necessary step which should be taken to betterment of their business. So this is the which set apart from other business, because it communicate directly with the managers and the authorities to the customers.
Okay. Thank you.
Good evening, all. I am Thirumalesh, and I am explaining about benefits of online marketing. One of the important advantages of the online marketing is it gives high returns on investment. Through online marketing, we can reach the right customers at a much lower cost than the traditional marketing methods. So it provides a maximum returns to business. And another important advantage is time and effort saving. We can advertise a cheaper through online marketing with compared to traditional methods, like advertisements such as a newspaper, on television, or radio. It doesn't require a huge investment in online marketing. Another advantage is flexibility. Through online marketing, it allows you to make changes. For example, if you make some errors or simple misprint, then online marketing allows business owners to change around the text or images after publishing also.
Yes.
And online marketing is very impactful compared to the traditional methods. It gives us the ability to target specific customers you think they are likely to purchase your product. Search engine optimization allows you to reach those customers who are searching the web for content and topics that relevant to your business. And online marketing gives instant feedback. After customers, we can deliver the products. After delivering the product, we can directly reach the feedback from customers. And another important advantage of online marketing is real-time analysis. Digital online marketing analytics takes the guesswork out of determining whether your marketing is actually working or not. You can see which tactics or strategies are working or not. Mm-hmm. By understanding the our business scenario, you can take necessary steps to improve our results.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Thirumalesh. Fantastic. Oh, that's great job. Simple. What is digital marketing? What is the objective of digital marketing? What are the different means? What are the different benefits? Fantastic. Good job. Crisp and excellent job. Thank you very much, team number 6. You did a great job. Let's give a big round of applause to Team 6 as well. Some messages of appreciation coming there. Thank you very much. That is a big round of applause to all the 6 teams. Can I request you to unmute and clap for all the 6 teams once? I really loved the presentation. Amazing. Awesome. Awesome. Awesome work. Great work. Really. So much of insight. That really tells me how capable you are, how smart you are, how much potential you have in you. Great job, guys. You really rock. So much to learn. These are totally different, not covered in the book. I want you to work on, but you gave a good insight. I gave you a very short time. You're all in different places. You work together as a team. I could see, you know, you are in touch with your team members. You know, fantastic. Good job. Congratulations.